Mabuhay ang Pilipinas! Known as the Pearl of the Orient or Perlas ng Silanganan, the Philippine archipelago is made up of over 7,000 islands in the Pacific Ocean. Nearly 300 years ago, Spanish missionaries dedicated Bicol region south of Manila to Our Lady of Benefrancia for protection from the many typhoons that hit these islands each year. However, in the year 1993, a super typhoon from the west named Missionaries of the Poor hit Bicol and came to rest only a few meters from the Basilica of Our Lady of Benefrancia in Negus City, at the city's vast dump area.
And the road comes all the way around.
This is the Malatas. Uh-huh. This is the dump site.
From all the garbage that they gather, they may get about 50 pesos, which is about $1 from
we
all.
We visited yesterday, and we saw those hundreds of kids. We saw the flies all over. We saw the garbage heap that went on for yards and yards and yards. We saw, and the smell and the stench. And yet, oddly, that was the highlight of our visit. You know, it was. That's the wounds of Christ. The children with the sores and the bellies, infections, and the bellies that were all swollen with worms, and the red eyes, and the hungry looks in their faces, and reaching out for love. And yet they were so gentle and beautiful. These are the ones that we will take in, and we want to place right at the very center of the witness that we're giving the church and also for Christ.
And so the work began. The brothers began visiting the families that lived on the garbage dump. Brought them food, medicines, and clothing. They brought the children to school at our mission, taught them the faith, and gave them proper meals and clothing. Otherwise, these children would have stayed with their parents to search the dumps for a living. True to their identity, the M.O.P.s, as the Missionaries of the Poor are known, looked for the rejected and castaways of society and found many of these nameless faces. Many of these, they took to their mission and began to care for their needs.
As a mission of the poor, the way in which they saw you as the founder, Father, going among the children and the joy you felt in meeting the poor, I really knew the brothers were struck by that.
Another aspect of the brothers' ministry is to visit and assist poor families living in the slums. Typically, slum dwellers live in huts like this, made up of plastic sheets and dry palm leaves. The brothers also run weekly food line for the elderly. One of those who regularly benefit from this program is Elpidio, who is totally blind and has a family of 8 children. Talented at music, he begs for a living by singing and playing guitar at the city's market. The formation house of the Missionaries of the Poor in the Philippines is packed with many local vocations who are formed in prayer and community life, taught scripture, and trained to work among the poor.
We recall from our previous classes, you as young aspirants and postulants and brothers of the Missionaries of the Poor must be able to recognize the root of your life. Everything you do, everything you are, Everything you say is rooted in the life of Jesus Christ.
There is also recreation and fun in the community. Music brings joy and hope into people's lives and uplifts their hearts in prayer to God. It is a powerful means of bringing the good news of Christ to people, especially to those whose lives are darkened by suffering and sin. The witness of the brothers has drawn many local lay associates.
The poor, it really gave me an immense joy, peace in my heart, which I never experienced in the business world. That's why I think after 10 years, I can say that I truly understand what is heaven like.
Can you tell me how this all happened? Could you explain to me how all this happened?
The simplest word I could use to explain what has been happening, Father, is really a miracle. A miracle. This is literally a miracle of the Holy Spirit. People came, they really felt that the brothers were touching the poor, were helping the sick and the children in the streets. Some of them even came to our house and they saw like little brother Max cooking. So they were very moved, and so they began to give us food because brother Max cannot cook, Father.
Well, I think he cooks better than you.
I was moved by the brothers from the different countries who came here as missionaries of the poor, serving the poor. So I am here also to share my work for them and to experience the joy in serving the Lord through the poor.
As Archbishop Legaspi said, he wants the Filipino church to be a church of the poor. So when he met you in 1992, it was like a dream come true, because he
made me feel like I went back to the time of Christ when he was born in Bethlehem. He came as a poor man. And there I experienced an awesome feeling that I was in his time. The happiness that I get from all these things available in the world is nothing compared to the happiness and joy and peace that you get whenever you feel that you're given a chance to help poor people, because I see in them Christ. It's like I am given the opportunity to serve God in flesh.